Hello, it's Swan here, and welcome back to another video, and today we are back playing EFC, just because, you know what, I quite enjoyed it last time, and I've just been wanting to play some more, so we're going to do just that. What I might as well do, instead of just flashing up my deck, is show you it, and talk about why I've chosen my cards. If you don't care, here's a timestamp for where the matches begin, but for my deck, I'm playing half Dominion and half Pussycats. The reason I went for Pussycats is just because I thought it makes sense to have the damage reducers in there. So of course, I can use them maybe round 1 and 2, trying to dampen any damage which my opponent might do to me. And then round 3 and 4, I can use the full advantage of the Dominion bonus. That was really my main thought process there. What I've gone for is Goose, just because, mainly due to his high power and his ability with the Pill Manip and Life Manip is quite handy. Gaboom, primarily just for the damage manip. Next up, Lordoon, just because that attack manip, especially when you've got Dominion's 4 bonus, is really, really nasty. Good base stats with quite high damage. Low power, but of course, as long as you're playing him when your opponent's got, well, even just 6 power, it matches quite well. Spectral Arcan, just because I feel like he's quite handy with his ability being victory or defeat. Means that at least you'll still get something back, but if you at least win with him, then he's essentially what, a 7-5 minimum for something like that. Charlie CR, using her as a 4-star just because I thought 5-star might take up a bit too much space in my deck, and of course the reason I've gone for that is so you essentially get to the -4 damage minimum 1. Kaiserin, see, I would have gone for maybe Shatzi or Agent Nerves, but I just figured Shatzi might not be the best deal because in EFC you can't really guarantee that you'll be playing mono decks, so it made sense to have something which was more a stable 8 power or whatever, rather than having a card where you might only get to use him at 7 power or even 6 power if you're up against a SOA clan. Went for Kaiserin, again mainly for the Pill Manip. A little bit of a shame, but she's got quite low damage, but if I get like a Pill Manip and then I can follow up with Dominion, that would be quite handy. Miss Stenner, just because she's got really good base stats. Her ability's a tiny bit of a pain, just because of course it affects both cards, but at least if we both ordered and say my opponent's got 7 power or less, he'll be reduced to 0, whereas I'll be at least at 1 attack, so that works quite nicely. And then you've got Nabrissa, who of course works quite nicely with Pussycats, and even like Spectral Arcan, if I just use him, or even Kaboom, could work very nicely together. So that's a little bit of my thought process there. Let's go actually delve into the games and see how well this deck actually fares, because I might do all that talking and it's just actually no good. Who knows? King Pwns, and of course. So, the main downside with this deck is it's still a bit heavily hindered by SOB, and of course I get bloody Nightmare, which is not what I wanted. Right, so I'm having a look around, and part of me feels like he'd first go for Sis, just because of course he'd want that Toxin. So I'm inclined to go for Kaiserin or maybe even Goose. Either or really can work well, but Goose might be better just because, of course, he's got a higher minimum. The only downside is if he maybe went for Askarov, because that would not be very good. But I'll start out by going about 6 pills, I reckon. Just because... Oh, is he going to go for Baffo? Oh no. So I get BP'd round 1, which is not good. I probably should have gone one more because that was, I guess, a bit. Could have maybe been a bit obvious there. What we got next then? What's he going to go for? Dragomir would be the obvious, but he might want to go for that round 4 and maybe use Sis instead. Just part of me feels like Kaiserin would be maybe the better shout. He probably knows if he went for Askarov, I'd just follow with Kaboom. So, would he go for Sis maybe? But then I could go for either Kaiserin or Miss Denner. See, this is one of the few times where Miss Denner is quite disadvantageous for me, because of course if he tries to go for Askaroth, then with me being reduced down to 6 power, her ability is really going to hurt me. But he's going to go for Oh, he's sort of like toing and throwing. Is he going to go Askaroth? No. Okay, I think he's clearly doing some sort of calculations. But he goes for Sis. Would maybe Freon Kaiserin be a bit safe? Because at least then, if he holds, I'll at least reduce him to the same pills as me. But if he plays, then at least that'll knock him down a few more. Do I go 4 maybe? Yeah. I think 3 might be a bit too risky, so I'll go 4 on Kaiserin instead. Ah, no. Not good. Okay, that's not fantastic for me. So, he can now win because all he needs to do is just hold him, and then he can go for Dragomir round 4. So, that is over. Never mind. I'll just go all Miss Denner, but yeah. There's nothing I can really do here. I maybe could afford Miss Denner. Oh no, okay. Wait. We might be okay. Well, let's see. About 5. So that's 6, which he's going to do. So 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. That's going to be a draw. But you know what? Considering that I thought we'd lost that, I'll take it. Aedadak Sayori. Okay, Geist and Frozen. Part of me feels like Kaboom would actually be quite a good opener here. Just because he's probably the card which is least affected by SOA other than Charlie, but I don't want to use it yet. And even if he plays one of his Frozen, then yeah, I'll still get some Palminip. Just that Elekporoth isn't great. But I'm thinking Kaboom probably maybe just 3 on it. Because I really don't want to play all that much on it. Yeah, Elekporoth, kind of what I would have thought. Okay, yeah, it goes 20, but I wouldn't have played that many pills on him. Is he now going to go for Wrecked? Would make sense. It's what I would expect. Yeah, he does. So I could still go maybe Spectral, I suppose. That wouldn't be a too bad play. Yeah, now, I want to save Spectral just because he can at least counteract Frozen if they get their bonus. So maybe Kaiserin. We'll just go maybe 3 on Kaiserin, yeah. Ah, no. Okay. And then I highly doubt there's any way which I can win here. Yeah, so if I went for Charlie, he'd probably just go for Cromper LD. But then I can't do enough damage with Spectral to win. So I kind of have to go for Spectral. But then you get the ability. Yeah, this is just lost. Because basically if I go for Spectral, well, yeah, he just is going to want to get the bonus with Cromper and win from that. But if I went for Charlie, he would have just gone all in Cromper, so no matter what I did there, there was just no winning. That was just finished. Okay, we're dropping down, we're not going in the right direction. Let's go into the next game, and fingers crossed, things will go a bit better. Okay, rescue. Also not great for me, to be honest. I suppose at least I've got Lord Dune. But a lot of it really is not good. Leonard. He's got that kill shot. Do I go Goose round one, maybe? And then I can, like, go Kaboom round two, potentially. Or I could go even Miss Denner, maybe. No, Miss Denner would be too risky because he's then more likely to get that kill shot. So I feel like Goose is a better shout. Just don't want him to get the kill shot, really. But I don't want to overpill it either. I'll go just five, but it might only play two free pills. Just one. So, overpilled there. Could have played a bit less, realistically. Do I just go Kaboom round two, maybe? He's got that goob, which kind of affects the Lord Doom, which is not great. But yeah, well, old Kaboom, really obvious, but at least then. Oh, is he going to go for Goob? Please tell me he does, because that'd be spot on. Okay, yeah. But that's fine. So now the maximum he can do would be 52. No, it'd just be 50, wouldn't it? But I can only do 45 with Lord Dune. If he goes Donald, then I'll just old again and use Lord Dune. Yeah. That should be completely fine, because I can just go Miss Denner and then go Lord Dune round four. To be fair, I wouldn't even need to do that. But yeah, of course, I'm being completely wrong here, because maximum he can do is 40. Well, it'd be 52, but minus 15, so that's like 40, 38. So I'll just play all my pills to be extra safe. But no matter what, I've won here. There we go. Just Lord Dune is such a good card. He just really is fantastic. Hashtag king, hashtag pussycats this time against Ghost Town. Okay, so he's got that revenge. He's got that victory and defeat. So part of me feels Miss Denner might be a better option. I kind of feel like I wouldn't want to go too effy. But he does have Taurite, which isn't great for my Miss Denner. But I'll go maybe about three pills on her. Just because at least if she doesn't go Taurite, like I kind of expected. Perfect. That's really good. So he now gets a revenge with Dakota. But even then, Dakota's not really an issue, because at least Ghost Town, they're in their night stage, so she doesn't get that one extra damage. And because I'm playing damage minute per Arthur, they're not going to get that much life from Dakota either. Part of me feels Kai Sarin. I'll go maybe just two pills, so that again, if I don't win here, at least I'm not at too much of a pill disadvantage. And if he wins, then at least I get the Nibiru's ability. And yeah, mainly due to that. Okay. Shit ton of pills. He probably was expecting that I would have gone all in there. Okay. So now I've got Nibiru, but I need to make sure that I can still win with Charlie. which I've kind of buggered. Really, the only option here is Old Nebrissa and then go Charlie round 4, maybe? I think that's the best option, maybe. Yeah. Yeah. 100%. As long as he plays at least one pill, then I can win for chart. Oh, he just goes Bambino. Okay. But that is still completely fine, because I have now won here. Because maximum he can do is 48. And I can do... Oh, shit. 48 on... Now I've thrown it here, haven't I? Yeah. No. Oh. Completely threw that one away. Damn it, I was... That's really annoying. I thought I'd won that there, but I hadn't. That's just me being a bit stupid. Okay, Fang Pai. It's got a lot of power manip, but at least I've got... Well, it's like a split between Dominion and Pussycats this time. Just that Bowden power. It's really scary, but at least I've got Kaboom. To be fair, no matter what you place, I might just go Kaboom round 1, to be honest. And then I suppose at least I can use Nebrissa round 2. But that might be a bit obvious, to be fair. Faye CR, using him as a 3-star semi-evo is a pretty solid idea. Oh, it just goes Lang Yuan. So that kind of ruins my plan of going for Kaboom. But I suppose Miss Denna makes a lot more sense now. So I could go for her instead. I don't know if he'd play that much. Probably not, because he'd want to save his pills for more his other cards. So I might only go about 3 on Miss Denna, I reckon. Oh, should have gone 4. At least it's only done 2 damage though, which is better. See, it's trickier because he's just got so much more damage than I do. So that really puts things in a bit of a pickle for me. But I've got Lord Doon, who should help me out a lot with that attack minute. So what would he likely go for? Probably Faye. More so, I reckon. So, might have to go for Nebrissa, but quite a lot of hills, maybe. Closer to 6. Could have maybe just ulted again, because, of course, he's still got that 8 power. Oh, so he just ulted. So... I'm pretty sure I've lost here. Yeah. We play either as Old Kaboom or just go all in Lord Doon. It might be better... What call do I make? Because if I play Lord Doon now, then that means if he Furies Bowden power, he could still do 8, which would drop me down to 4. But would going for Lord Doon round 4 be a bit too obvious? Maybe, because he's probably then going to play enough pills to cover if I were to go for Lord Doon round 4. Or do I Fury Lord Doon maybe? Yeah. Is that a bit risky? But yeah, I feel like he'd expect me maybe to go back. It's risky. But if I Fury Lord Doon, that's maybe my best option at potentially winning here. Which I think I have. Yeah, 100%. Good. Because now he can only do a maximum of 3. So 100% the right call. Good. I panicked, but we got there. Do I go maybe one more game? I don't know. I kind of said that last video and I just kept playing. I reckon so. One more and we'll call it there. I was gonna say I wouldn't say I've done too terribly, but I've not done amazingly. But what I can tell you is this deck, which I'm up against now, is horrendous. Goes Alucard, which makes absolute sense. I don't think he would pill really anything, would he? So do I maybe go Mistena around just old it? Might be my best shout. It's got that jar in, it's got a mirror. Nasty. But do I want to risk losing that 5 power? I don't know. Yeah, I'll go for that because even if he plays, I suppose, one pill, he will only do 1 damage, so that's not terrible. Okay. Goes 4 on Alucard. And at least Nabrissa's right opposite Jarin, so I can prevent him going for that. But he would go for Sabos. But I can live with that. Just, I feel like I'm kind of walking myself into a bit of a death trap because he's got that Emir, he's got Jarin. I kind of need to save Nabrissa then, don't I? So I don't risk. See, I really want to save that Nabrissa, but especially with that Emir and Jarin, it's just kind of a bit horrendous. Really, really horrible matchup. Really bad. I'll just go about 5 on Charlie, because I'm expecting kid to go for Sabos. Oh no, it's going Jarin. I guess that makes sense. Oh! Ah, that's not good. And I'm pretty sure this looks kinda over for me. Because even if I get... Yeah. Even if I tried to go for Nabrissa, I wouldn't be able to do enough damage to counter Emir. And with Emir, that's going to drop me down to 5-3. Which... 7 times 5, 35. I just can't counter that. That was just... I had an absolutely terrible hand and he had one which just... I could not go up against. This hand just isn't working for me. I thought Pussycats and Dominion would be a good combo, but... No, I don't think so. Just absolute obliteration. I am going to leave it there, because this is not going well for me. I'll make some sort of return to EFC. I'll just have to rethink what I'm playing and hopefully do a bit better. I've been Itzwan, thanks for watching, and goodbye.